be shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul rejoices beyond a breeze, a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, no. Truly he taught us love for one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains he shall break, for the slave is brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus praise we, let all within us praise his heart.
Good evening. My name's Kerry Jackson and I'm the executive of St Gemma's Hospice. It's a real pleasure to welcome you this evening to this special online Light Up a Life service. Light Up a Life this year is taking place in a very different and uncertain world. I'd love to be welcoming so many people as I do every year to St Gemma's. Usually we have to stand in the freezing cold, and often it's raining too, but it's always a special occasion. And this evening is different, but no less special. St Gemma's has worked so hard in recent months to make sure that we continue providing our vital care to patients and family, both here at the hospice and in people's own homes. And all that care continues to be provided thanks to you, our community. We are thinking, as we do every year at this time, of the special call we are all missing and remembering. We've all been through so much change and loss in this difficult pandemic year. For some of you, a loved one may have died during this difficult year. For others, you may have been bereaved less recently. Perhaps being separated from family and friends has made that loss and grief harder to bear. But however you're in this evening, and whatever your situation, we hope that you find that these are precious moments to think about the loved ones that you are missing. Light is a symbol of life and hope, and by lighting up precious lives, we hope that we feel not alone, that you are together with many others, sharing evening as part of our St Gemma's community. If you'd like to, you can make comment section under this live stream. You can share messages remembering your loved ones, or perhaps provide words of hope and encouragement for each other, so that we all feel together this evening. I want to thank you for dedicating your lights and sending in the names of those people. Your amazing generosity has already raised over £6,000 for St Gemma's. I'd also like to thank Northern Rail Pinnacle Group, who've sponsored our event this evening. Very soon, we will ask you to light your candles at home, and the thousands of Christmas trees will be switched on at St Gemma's, and all the lights will then burn brightly as one. I'd now hand over to Peter McAvoy, who leads our spiritual care service here at the hospice, and will lead us all tonight in the light of candles, a moment of silence, the switching on of the Christmas tree lights.
We come together to take time to reflect, pray, and remember all those we have loved. All our memories will be different, and we seek comfort in being together and sharing in this service with each other. The content of today's service has been compiled recognizing that not everyone attends a place of worship, prays, or has a faith. For some people, prayer is important. For others, it is being with their deep thoughts that is important. So however you approach service, let's pray, let's bear our own thoughts, and in remembrance as we prepare for Christmas in a very changed year, let us remember constancy of love. Love never fails. Love always protects. Love always trusts. Love always perseveres. Love always hopes. I invite you at home to light your candles in memory of those you have loved, and I will then read a short poem. As we enter this special time and share time of remembrance, we light a candle in your memory. The times we laughed, the times we cried, the times we were angry with each other, the siblings you did, the caring and joy you gave us. We light this candle for our love, so that your light will always shine. With family and friends, we cherish the special place in our hearts that will always be reserved for you. We thank you for the gift your living brought to each of us. Now a short prayer. God of life, promise and hope, in the darkness help us to see light. May it shine us and spread light in our lives. May our lights lit today glow brightly as one. Amen. And now, as we wait for the trees to be lit up, we'll pause for a moment of quiet reflection.
Different passing comments to staff over years of things that somebody might wish to do or want, or like something like afternoon tea on the balcony in the sunshine with maybe a glass of Prosecco or two. Different thing, date nights with their other halves, you know, just in the rooms watching a DVD and a bottle of wine even, pizza. We've done all sorts. We've done makeovers. Staff have brought dresses in and even on some occasion wigs, just to dress somebody up to go to a wedding or an event. And it's just been nice to make people, it's that getting to know them and getting to know what they're like and the personalities and what they'd really enjoy. And then if we can fulfil a wish or some event that they want to be at, then we try as hardest to do it. Mm-hmm. And not just the girls on the ward, it's a whole team, it's everybody, an effort from the whole of St Gemma's really. So back in 1989, and I was 17 years old, and I didn't realise the impact St Gemma's would have on me, like that I'd still be here all this time later. I've celebrated passing my driving test here, where I've come in and the staff room was full of learner plates and balloons, and we had cake and tea, and I've had my 18th birthday celebrations here, my 21st. I've got married, I've had my daughter, brought her in and showed her off. She's now 24 nearly. You know, I've celebrated so many life-changing events and stuff and gone through loops and downs, and with my work family, basically, my friends, my colleagues, they're like family to me, so yeah, it's been lovely over the years. And we do with others on the wards as well, and all our other colleagues celebrate things with them, the ups and downs in life. Mm. But it's lovely. Yeah, it really is a nice place to work. With the restrictions of COVID, it's really strange on the wards. Obviously, something I've not been used to, none of my colleagues are used to. We're wearing the full PPE and that, but we still manage to do them little things on the wards with somebody. Like the other day, for instance, this lady I was looking after, it's the first time I've met her. She really wanted a bath, but she was unable to have a bath. So I said, come on, let's go for this wash by the side of the bed, everything, and we'll get chatting and talking. I got to know her. And she mentioned while we were talking that every Thursday her hairdresser comes to her house. And obviously with lockdown and restrictions, it's not always happened, but she loved her hair being blow-waved. And I said, right, we'll do that today for you after we've finished your wash. We'll get your hair blow-waved and we'll style it, you know. And she was absolutely over the moon, she couldn't believe it. She got dressed out of a nightie, she felt a little bit brighter by the end of the wash. And then her son walked on the ward, and he was just like, Mother, I can't believe it, you look amazing today, you look so much brighter and better. And she said, I feel it. And she said she felt like she'd known me for years, because we've been chatting about her life, how she met her husband, what her family did, you know, and everything that, what she did, how sociable she was and how COVID affected her, because at 86 years of age, she'd worked in retail all her life, meeting people, and to be in a ward with just one bed and no other patients around her, and you know, we come in as best we can, but she was just saying how different life is, but at 86 year old, to get used to that is hard, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So we had a lovely time getting to know each other, and she said, I absolutely made a day, which was lovely, and she made mine too, listen to her. I love just finding out about the history and what they've gone through in life. I do feel very fortunate to work here at St Gemma's. I'm really lucky, actually. And I do feel privileged to work here. And I do thank everybody for all the support, because without your support, we wouldn't have this wonderful organisation and the care and the love that we give to people through our time. So it's really appreciated. Thank you very much.
I will light a candle for you to scatter all the darkness and bless the times we knew, like a beacon in the night. The flame will burn bright and guide us on our way. So today I light a candle for you. The seasons come and go, and I'm weary from the change. I keep moving on. You know it's not the same when I'm walking all alone. Do you hear me call your name? Do you hear me sing the songs we used to sing? You filled my life with wonder, touched me with surprise. Always saw that something special deep within your eyes, through the good times and the bad. We carried on side by side with pride. I hold on to that love and the life we knew. I will light a candle for you to scatter all the darkness and bless the times we knew. Like a beacon in the night, the flame will burn bright and guide us on our way. So today, I light a candle for you.
Those we love remain with us, for life itself lives on. And cherished memories never fade because a loved one's gone. Those we love can never be more than a thought apart. For as long as there is memory, they'll live on in the heart. After the closing song, we will display your loved one's names on the roll of honour, with some background music to help aid reflection and remembrance. The Roll of Honour will play for approximately 30 minutes, and that will bring our service to a close.
To bring this evening's Light Up a Life to a close, our wonderful singer Carolyn will perform Stand By Me. We chose Stand By Me because even though we can't physically stand beside each other tonight, we do stand together in remembrance and the love of those we are remembering and missing. Even when we are facing dark nights, they are made easier when we stand together in light, love and hope. From everyone here at St Gemma's Hospice, thank you for joining us this evening and our warmest wishes to you for Christmas and the New Year. Thank you.
Just as long as you stand by me. Thank you.
Thank you.